Sir.
Now I request that you unmute all 150 participants which have joined. And participants, please unmute your mic. If it is not necessary, ask questions, okay? Because I want... Okay. So, Kuldeep sir, just talk to me, Kuldeep sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can they unmute themselves?
No, sir. Not allowed.
Not allowed. Okay, no, can they write in chat box?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so I can keep a track of chat box, and if I say that allow him to speak, can you do that for me, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
If you allow.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Okay. So we'll start the session now. Is Word file visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Right. My question to all of you is, you can write down in the chat box if you want, right? I'll start with the questions. And definitely we are going to talk about... just a minute. Just a minute. Yeah, that was a problem. Now, what is truth? Okay. And everything is linked with structural equation modeling only. What is truth? Please write in the chat box. I'm monitoring. Okay. Please write your views on it. What is truth? Key will be given in your Gmail. What is truth? Please drop your answer in it. Anybody who wants to say what is truth? A fact or a reality. Very nice. Good. So a truth is something which remains constant over time, place, and person. The example is, sun rises from east. Yeah, sun rises from the east. Now, in this statement, we don't have any variations. We don't have any variations, which means that the standard deviation will be zero. Okay. It means that there will not be a difference of opinion in this statement. Now comes the second statement. Winters are very depressive. So this is the point now in which there is a difference of opinion. There are variations. There are variations. Standard deviation will no longer be equal to zero. Right. Now, what is difference between our traditional regression and structural equation modeling? Smoking induces the cancer. Smoking causes cancer. It is a very well clear cut that this is an independent variable affecting the dependent variable. Very clear cut scenario in which smoking causes cancer. But there can be a scenario in which we are not clear that what is IV and what is DV. For example, crime rates are increasing because of the TV serials. When you ask to the producers of the TV serials, they will say, we are just showing what is happening in the society. We are not clear what is IV and what is DV. We are not at all clear. It is quite confusing that what to keep as dependent variable and what to keep as independent variable. So now the scenario arises. Just a minute. So wait a minute, all of you, just a minute. So now the scenario arises that how to fix the independent and dependent variable. And now the concept of no longer dependent and independent variable exists. Now we are in that, we say that it is endogenous and exogenous. It is an endogenous and exogenous. Again, the problem is that the thing which we can measure directly, for example, I will give you an example to this, is blood pressure. You can measure directly with the instrument. Weight, you can directly measure with the instrument. Okay. Temperature. But now comes a variable which is temperament of a person. This is difficult. Now this is no longer a variable and now it is known as construct, which means that to measure the construct we are using some other variables which represents this as a construct. Okay. Don't get confused. I'll try to make it more and more simple. I always use a very layman language. For example, there are various teams, sports teams. There are various sports teams which are representing in Olympics from India. One is from football, swimming, hockey, and they are representing for India. Okay. Now, this team does not have any physical identity. But this football team is representative of some players whose performance can be measured. Whose performance can be measured. right? India does not have, in the sense, any physical identity like man and woman, but it's a construct. It means that India is represented in Olympics by these teams. And football team does not also have a physical identity. It is measured. The performance of the football team is measured by the players which are there inside. So now this is a construct and this is a variable. Similarly, in our marketing or in HR, we face a similar problem. The problem is that there are some constructs like loyalty, satisfaction, commitment. These are all constructs and they cannot be measured directly. You can never ask an employee directly in the organization. You must all have seen that advertisement. Okay. The advertisement is, kya aapki toothpaste mein namak hai? Now, what does that mean? A direct question. It is completely a direct question. So similarly, can I ask to any employee in the organization, are you satisfied in this organization? Now, why I cannot measure directly? Because satisfaction is a construct. And he will immediately ask me, if the employee is there for years, that fine, you are asking me, are you satisfied in this organization? But satisfaction is related to what? Are you talking about wages? Are you talking about the recognition? Are you talking about the health services? Okay. So now I am not able to answer this because I have asked direct question. Are you satisfied in this organization? Yes and no, which we can never ask. And therefore, this construct has to be broken down into some variables which can be measured directly. So now we have understood something, that there is a construct and there is a relationship, and both are confusing. Construct and their relationship. You can say, the marital status is confusing, that how to keep both of them. So say, for example, now I am saying that satisfaction, a construct, commitment, a construct, is affecting the loyalty. Moreover, commitment is also affecting the satisfaction. Right. So, entire system which is there, and for this purpose, we require structural equation modeling. Okay. So, first of all, we will have to measure the structural model. And then, first of all, we will have to go for measurement model and then we go for structural model. Now, what is the difference between these two? Let's try to understand. When you make a house, for example, you are constructing a house. I'm just making a small, you are making a house. Okay. So, when you are testing the outer walls, that how strong our outer walls are, then it is known as reliability and validity testing of the model. after this is perfect, you can arrange your furniture inside in whatever way you want, right? So when you want to work inside the house, it is known as inner model. This is known as outer model. This is known as inner model. And here when you test, then you are using some parameters like adjusted R square, F square, Q square. So first of all, we test the outer model and then we test the inner model. The question arises that how to test the outer model. Again, I will come back to the football team. I want that the players represent the football team in Olympics, and therefore I'm trying to pick up a handpick the sportsmen from the group of sportsmen which are available. Okay, group of sportsmen which are available. Now I will not pick up each and every person randomly. I will pick them up on their some performance. So I will have to see that how their performance is. Then only I will allow them in the football team. Just imagine that this football team is our loyalty and these are all statements. I cannot blindly go on dropping the statements. I can only allow those statements which represent the construct very well. And the criteria which I have kept is that the minimum performance which is to be given by this player or this statement is 50%. And that is known, the 50% performance should be given by this, at least 50% performance should be given by this player or this statement. Now I'm taking four statements or four players, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I want that their performance should be above 0.5. Why I want that? So that my overall performance is good. So when I am talking about individual 50%, it is known as variance extracted. And when I am talking about the overall, it is known as average variance extracted, which should be more than 50%. Then only our construct is working properly. In smart PLS, you will not get this figure as 50%. Instead of this, you will get the path coefficients. Okay. Now, what is the relationship of variance with the path coefficient? It is just a square root of it. So when you take a square root of 50%, it should be 0.708. It means that this is a loading. This is a loading. And this loading, 0.708, if you take the square of it, you get 50%. This means that when Smart PLS generates the output, this should be more than 0.708. This should be more than 0.708. Then only this construct is affecting this construct. When you achieve this, it is known as reliability achieved. There are other measures of reliability also, which includes Cronbach alpha, composite reliability. But believe me, friends, they are all part of the correlation among this team players. There is another scenario, and that is known as validity. Now, what is this validity? Let's try to understand. There are now two teams, right? One is the football team. And another is a swimming team. there are players which are here also, players which are here also, and the players which are here also. Now, there is one particular sports person who knows both of them. Right. He wants to participate in both of them. Right. So, what our model will say, you are not allowed to participate in both the team at the same time. Either you participate here or you participate here. If a particular sportsman participate in both the teams, then we say that the divergent validity is lost. In simple words, if a statement is showing a relationship with two constructs, then we say that the divergent validity is lost. So, first we have to test the outer walls of our house. First, we have to make them concrete. It should be reliable. It should have a validity. And if it is clear, so the first part of these 2 hours, we will be just talking about how to make our walls concrete. And if the outer wall is clear, we will start fixing up the furniture in our house properly, and we will make our structural model effective. I am trying to give you another example of divergent validity again. Another way. You must have observed the torch and its focus.
Dear participants, there is message from Dhawal sir. Please stay connected. There is power cut at his hand. He'll be joining soon. Please stay connected.
Now?
Not yet, sir.
Just a minute.
Is it? Yes, visible? Sir. Now it is visible, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now see. Okay. Now see the DLS, it's a prediction oriented, and covariance is a parameter oriented. It means that suppose you are giving new observations to the model which we have constructed in the smart PLS, we can use it for the predictions also. This is non-parametric based, that is a parametric based. This can work on small sample size, but the niche is this. The niche is it can work on formative also and reflective also. Now, what is the difference between formative and reflective? Let's try to see. Wait a minute. What is the difference between this? Just a minute. Now see, reputation affects satisfaction. Satisfaction affects loyalty. So here, reputation is your exogenous, satisfaction is endogenous and exogenous both, and loyalty is endogenous. Okay. Wait a minute. Now I want to do something okay. What is a formative and a reflective skin? What happened first? Chicken or egg? Similarly, here also, there can be a problem of the construct. I have given you the example, the team players. Now see, this is a degree of drunkenness which is there. A drunk person will show these features. Interaction ability, ability to walk in a straight line, and the reaction rate, he will not be able to react well. So these are all the consequences of being drunk. But if a person wants to get drunk, what are the causes? So he can consume beer, he can consume spirits, time passed in alcohol. So when it is causes, it is known as a formative. And when it is consequences, it is known as reflective. Till Smart PLS was launched, Amos was only working on reflective. We were working only on reflective measures. All our research was aligned towards reflective measures only. Now, can a construct at the same time be reflective also and formative also? It may happen. Let's try to understand this. Reflective. I appreciate this hotel. I am looking forward to stay in this hotel. I recommend this hotel to others. Reflective. What is the formative? What is the cause of satisfaction? The cause of satisfaction is service is good, personnel is friendly, and rooms are clean. So you can see at the same time, a construct can be reflective also and formative also. So now there is an horns of dilemma. Then how to resolve this? Is it a formative or reflective? Don't worry. In Smart PLS, we are having the statistics, we are having tools to identify that it is a formative or a reflective construct. Okay. With this understanding, let's start working in Smart PLS, all of you. Please start the Smart PLS in your system. Okay. Please follow my instructions. Be very careful in the sense it is very simple to learn. I'm going very slowly. Okay. If you want that, if you want some questions, you can drop in chat box. I will be monitoring on the chat box. Okay. I hope now the Smart PLS is there with you. Right. Please follow my instructions. Open file. Create new project. Okay. Create new project. Before we try to analyze that what is there, let me give you what is the example all about. What is the example all about? Let me try to give you. The example is we have to reach here. All of you. Yeah. There is a problem in chat box. No. We have to reach here. All of you, just a minute. We have to reach here. We want to say that job satisfaction is affecting the staying intention of an employee. Organizational commitment is affecting the staying intentions of an employee. Environmental perception is affecting staying intention of an employee. And co-worker is affecting staying intention. Now, this job satisfaction, just try to recall my team, the football team. These are players. Okay, these are all players, and the performance of the construct will be evaluated on the basis of the performance of this statement. We have to reach here. Now let's try to see what are the statements which are there, which can be measured directly. So the statements of job satisfaction are, these are the statements. All things considered, I feel very satisfied when I think about my job. When you think about your job, how satisfied do you feel? How satisfied are you with your current job with HBAT? Now, HBAT is, this is a data file of a very celebrated authors of multivariate data analysis, Black, Anderson and Tatham. Very nice book on multivariate data analysis. So these are the statements for the construct job satisfaction. Now comes our swimming team. The swimming team players are, my work at HBAT gives me a sense of accomplishment. I am willing to put in a great deal. I have a sense of loyalty. Now comes our hockey team. These are its four players. Okay, then comes the another team, co-workers. And last comes the staying intention, the endogenous. Okay, so let's try to construct the model. We were here. You can give any name. I am giving HBAT. Click OK. Click OK. Anywhere if you face a problem, first of all, don't get disturbed. Just write in the chat box, sir, I am facing this problem. Okay. Those who have not loaded the software, I cannot help in that matter right now because we have given the instructions yesterday only that please do it. And it was just a matter of 10 minutes. It was not a very complicated process. Not even 10 minutes. It's just a matter of 5 minutes. Okay. Now just see. Double click to import the data. Here there is some icon is there. Okay. Double click and again a window will pop up. I have sent you one file. This file I have already sent you. Just click open. Click OK. And the file is there in your system. All those who are able to do it, at least drop in chat box OK so that I can understand that you are able to, you are with there with me, at least one or two people. I am monitoring on chat box. And if you everybody is posting, then it's very nice. I will be really happy because OK is just like a clapping for me. OK. Yes, Purti was not visible from left. OK. It is just like a clapping for me that I am able to do these things. Fine. Now, just see. Now, click on this blue and a canvas will appear. A canvas will appear. Okay. A canvas will appear. This is a palette. Now comes how to transfer the variable. See, one way is just drag and drop. Be with me. You will not do anything. Don't do anything. Only one variable will come. I don't want that. I want the bunch of variables to be picked up. So let me see the model. What is the model? First part which I have to make is job satisfaction. And my team players are JS1, JS2, JS3, JS4. Let us try to pick that up. Now, how will I do this? JS1. But as soon as I click JS2, JS1 is gone. See. So how to do the simultaneous selections of all of them? JS1, press control. Keep control on only, which is on your left-hand side bottom. Then JS2. Then JS3. And then JS4. Drag it and drop it. If you are able to do it, write in the chat box, done. File I have sent is opening in all of them. Sir, it is opening in all of them. May I know who is it? Who is it facing problem? See, it is opening in all of them. It is opening in all of them. I am repeating the procedure. Don't worry. Don't get disturbed. Okay. Don't get disturbed. Believe me, after some time, you will start playing with this. JS1, press control. Control is below shift button. Left hand side, CTRL, it is written. Press it. Keep press on. JS1, then JS2, then JS3, and then JS4. With your mouse or with your touchpad, just drag it and drop it. Just write down done. Done? Fine. Very nice. Thanks, ma'am. Okay. let's move ahead. Now, which is another team in our thing? Organizational commitment. Our swimming teams comes into the picture. And now, who are the nominees of our swimming team? Let's try to see. OC1, OC2, OC3, OC4. Drag it and drop it. So now, another team is also there on the playground, which is another team which is there on the playground. Environmental perception. Bring EP1, EP2, EP3, EP4. Drag it and drop it. In case, suppose, if you miss any statement, no need to worry. No need to worry. If one player is left out, no need to worry. Just go in the waiting room, go in the lounge, call him that you are left or your players are already on the playground. Why you are sitting here? Drag it and drop it him and he will again be in the team. Who is next? Next is co-workers. The co-workers are AC1, AC2, AC3, AC4. Drag it and drop it. You can rearrange them very nicely by just clicking on red button. Right? Now comes the last part, that is staying intention. And the players are SI1 and SI4. Pick them up. SI1, SI2, SI3, SI4. Drag it and drop it. Sir, can you please tell again, actually per variable, separate latent variable also comes. Organizers, can you unmute Arpita, madam?
Arpita Goyal.
Yeah, Arpita Goyal. Can you
Kuldeep or Vishal, please unmute Arpita Goyal. Let me check.
Raghavendra ji, you want to restart after taking Excel file. Please can unmute. Yeah. Arpita madam, talk to me.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, please tell.
Sir, actually, I am putting the separate variable like JS1, JS2, but which is not come under same variable like latent variable.
Ma'am, see. When you will not drop the player in his team, naturally, he will create his own party.
Okay, sir.
Anna. So we want to create new political parties, right? So what we want, you should tell JS4 that please don't make your new party. Go there inside this only.
Okay, sir. Okay, fine.
Okay. Please.
Thank you, sir.
Please mute them. Yes, I want to talk to Raghavendra ji. Please, unmute Raghavendra ji. Yeah, what is the problem you are facing, Raghavendra ji? Excel file is hanging while downloading the file. No, not at all. It is happening, sir. It is happening in all of them. You can see. And there is no, it is not a bulky file also. At present, see the recording right now. See the things, how the things are going and try to do on the recording. In case if you face any problem, I'm dropping a number. I will solve your problem. No need to worry. Attend the session very nicely. I will drop my message. I will work on your any desk. No need to worry. Please attend the session. Okay. I can understand because of some reasons it may not work, but it is a very rare chance. Okay. All of you. Now see, those who are with me, press on this red and we want to shift on this side. Please do it. Those who have done it, drop it in the chat box. Done. No, JS5, we don't require JS5 because JS5 is on continuous scale and therefore JS5 is not taken. Jasmindeep Kaur ma'am, we have not taken it. Okay. Done. You are faster than me. Now, this JS1, JS4, they are on the playground, but they are asking to the referee that we belong to which team. Please give us the name. So all of you go here, right click and rename. And the name is job satisfaction. Do it. Those who have missed the bus, again, click on it, right click, rename. Organizational commitment. Click OK. Environmental perception. Behavior with co-workers or the behavior of our co-workers. Staying intention of the employees. Please complete it this much. If you have done it, just drop it in the chat box, done. And if you want me to wait, write down wait, sir. Okay, it is very simple thing. No complications are there. I have taken a very simple model. We are working on higher order constructs also, advanced level also. But at present, we have make it very, we want to understand very basic. Okay, done, fine. Now comes that you have to connect from here, pick up, connect this with this, this with this, this with this, and this with this. If everything turns blue, it's bingo. You have made your first model. And please write down in the chat box, done. Please write down. All of you write down, please. Please repeat. Yes, Arpita ma'am, I will repeat it for you. It is very simple. See, it is very simple. See, when I click here, you have to just pick up from connect. So connect and this connect and it will turn blue. Okay. Shall I proceed? Okay, shall I proceed? Fine. Now, just assume that this job satisfaction, which is our football team, and this is a referee. The referee is saying to these players that I am allowing you to play, but if you misbehave during the play, I will remove you. Okay, so here also, if any statement is found not playing properly, we will remove him. Is it clear? We will remove him, right? So where we will go now, all of you, calculate. All of you go in, calculate PLS algorithm. Make this as 500. These are the number of iterations which are being run to make the estimates stable. The author of this software, who is Ringel, Professor Ringel, Sarstad, they have suggested that at least when you're working on a model, you run this as 5,000. But you don't do that because it will take a lot of time and we have to complete many things in a short span of time. So you keep it 500 for the learning purpose. Start calculations. All of you start calculations. Please start calculations. Please start calculations. And now,
sir, sir, there is a request from participants to just repeat a bit.
Yes, sure. all of you, I am canceling this thing. I am again coming back here. Okay. At present, you will be on this stage. Be with me. Right. You are all at this stage. The players are ready. The team is ready. And now we are, the India is ready for the Olympics. Now we have to perform. So where we will see the performance? We have taken the team players and we want to check that now how they will perform in Olympics. Calculate. PLS algorithm. Start calculation. And you will get this result. Did you got this result? If you have got it, please write down in the chat box. Done. Done. Please write down. It gives me satisfaction or it motivates me. For my motivation, write down done. Okay. It is a small, simple word for you, but for me, it is a motivation. Good. Let's proceed. So, did you got this result, all of you? Check it. Did you got this result? Now, at present, we don't have to do anything right now in path coefficients, but we have to proceed from here and we want to test that how our outer loadings are working or how our team players are working. If you remember, I had given you the instruction that the performance should not go below 0.708. Can anybody tell me that which are the team players in which team which are not performing well? This is, you can see, all those which have turned red, they are not performing well. This is the same result which is there in your box. No, JS1 and JS4, they are not performing well. Right. Now the question arises, should I remove it or not? It is a very hard decision. Should I remove it or not? Okay. Should I remove it? Please write down in the chat box. Should I remove it? Anybody who is having any suggestion, should I remove it or not? They are not performing well. Why? Because, see, why those who want an explanation, take the square of 0.571. It will be less than 0.5. Take the square of 0.520. It will be less than 0.5. Now the question arises that why such criteria of 0.5 has been kept? Can anybody answer me that why such criteria of 0.5 has been kept? Anybody can tell me why the criteria of 0.5 is there? Because the criteria has been set 0.5 because the nature's probabilities of happening any event or not happening any event is 0.5. So if you are making a model, if you are making a statement, naturally its explanatory power should be more than the nature's probability. And if you are not able to explain more than nature's probability, why you are making a model? For example, be with me. I am giving a very layman example. I have made a model. Such models cannot be made. I am just trying to give you an example, a very layman example. Okay. I have made a model. And what is the model? That if you toss a coin 8 a.m. in the morning when humidity is 80%, wind is blowing from northeast, and if the coin flips in the air for 10 times, then there are 30% chance that you will get the heads. Is it a good model? Please drop in the chat box, good or bad model and the reasons for it. Please drop in the chat box, good model or a bad model. Is it a good model or a bad model? Yeah, it's a bad model. Why it's a bad model? Because your explanatory power of the model is less than the nature's probability of getting the head. If you don't make any model, then also 50% chances are there that you will get the head. And now you are making the model whose prediction power is less than 50%. And that's the reason we are saying that the statement should have at least explanatory power, which is more than 50%. If it is not able to explain that thing, that statement is not doing well. But should we drop it or not? Should we drop it or not? So, should we drop it or not? So, that is a big question. Now, same football team, let's try to understand. The players are there. Now, one of the players is not performing well. Should we remove it? No, you should not remove it. You should check the reliability and validity. If the presence of this variable is not altering the overall reliability of these four players, it may happen that this player is not performing well, but this player is able to bring so much correlation among these statements. And because of this, these team players are working well. Then you should check the reliability. And if the reliability is good, don't drop this variable. Let this variable allow them to play. Because the presence of this variable is motivating these team players also. And therefore, because of this team player, these statements are also working properly. So, let us try to see that is it what is happening on the overall reliability and of this team. So, please go in, wait a minute. This is outer model, this is inner model, this is already explained. Yeah. So, please go here in construct reliability and validity. Please click there. Please click there. You can see the overall performance of the team. It is above 0.5. Very good. Nothing to worry. There is no problem. We should not remove that sports person which is not playing properly today. So you can see the threshold limits which are there, which have been set for all of them is Cronbach alpha should be greater than 0.7. Rho should be greater than 0.7. Composite reliability should be greater than 0.7. Average variance extracted should be more than 0.5. And therefore, everything is green. It means that, bingo, no problem. But if any one of them was in red, then what to do? Okay, if any one of them was in red, it means that that team player is affecting the performance of the entire team. So in that scenario, okay, if you forget the threshold limit, not to worry, just click on Cronbach alpha graph and it will show you the bars. If all the bars are green, good, bingo, go ahead. Rho, go ahead. Composite reliability, go ahead. Average variance expected, go ahead. Okay. I will share with you that what happens when things are not working, how the graph looks. Just wait a minute. This will turn red. Okay. If you don't achieve the reliability or validity. Now, the question arises that what you will do if the team player is not working well. So this is the thing which I have created after reading the statements, after reading the papers of these authors. What is the first thing which is there? The first question which is there is your outer loading green or red? So in our case, it was red. JS1 and JS4 was red. Right. If it is green, AVE, CR, and they are green, reliability, validity achieved. We have achieved the team performance. Outer wall of our house has been constructed very well. nothing to worry. But suppose you got red, as we got red in our 4 or 5 statements, you check AV, CR, Cronbach, alpha and rho. Is it green? Yes, it is green. Don't delete that statement. Don't delete that variable. But suppose it is red. This is also red. Then what you will do? Delete that variable and again check AVV, CR and alpha. Okay? If it is turning out to be green, then only delete the variable. But if it remains red only, then there is a problem of data, problem of outlier, problem of unengaged respondent. Very big problem, which we face every day. Most of the time, you will get here only. Why? I will answer it now. Okay. Why you get this problem? I will answer it now. Be with me, all of you. Meanwhile, if you are having any question, please ask. Meanwhile, if you are having any question, you can ask. Right.
There are some questions in chat box. If you can see, sir.
It's a row measure. Composite row measure is used. I will tell you the philosophy of that, how it is calculated. Yes, you want to know it. I will tell you. Are you serious if you say 30%? Can I talk to this person, Subjit Arora? Can I talk to this person, Subjit Arora?
Can you please unmute Subjit Arora, Vishal or Kuldeep?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello,
yes, sir.
Yeah, Subjit sir, talk to me. Yeah, what is the question which you are having?
Sir, what you said was, if we are making a model, it should be more probability than 50%.
Right.
What you mean is that it should give you different than the naturally what could have happened.
Yes, 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 so definitely.
It doesn't really mean it should be more than 50%. Can be less than 50% also, then it could also make it a good
model. Subjit sir, now what is the probability that it will rain or it will not rain?
That depends.
No, we are just discussing, sir. It is 50-50.
Okay.
Now I have, say for example, I have installed the robust machineries and to predict that the rain will be, I have invested huge amount. And after investing this huge amount, I am able to predict that it will rain 30%. Today the chances are, my prediction is only 30% sure, that my surety is only 30%. Will you say that my investment is better?
See, you are saying surety to be 30%. You are not saying that 30% is what. In this case, you said 30% chance is there that heads will come. Your surety, you are saying 100% of 30% chances of this thing. You are now changing the example.
No. What I'm saying is there are 30% chance of prediction that it will get heads. I'm saying I'm not changing anything. If you feel that I...
Yes, when you are saying 30% heads will come, 70% tails, right? So that is what I'm trying to say.
Subjit sir is right. I agree with him. The success criteria is to be defined. I hope that is the correct word, Subjit sir. I am with you now.
Yes.
Yeah, yes. Subjit sir has appropriately pointed out. This is a very nice thing. Thank you, Subjit sir. What he wants to say is define your success criteria. So my success criteria is that if I get the heads, then that is my success. And if my model is predicting less than 50%, it means that the model is not working. Another example to it is there any other question, Subjit sir? Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you, Subjit sir. Thank you very much. I really appreciate that you are listening to me. Thank you, sir. Now, say for example, we are all in the vaccination process, and if the vaccination company says that there are only 10% chances that you will get protected, will you go for the vaccination? No, you will not go for the vaccination. That 10%. So what you want, at least it should be more than 50%. And that's the reason we are going for it. Okay. Now we say ID 1, ID 2, ID 3, ID 4. Now just see what is happening here. Suppose there is one respondent who is ticking everything like this, 5, 5, 5. And then there is one statement in which all the respondents are ticking 5, 5, 5. Now what will happen is, this is known as unengaged customer or unengaged respondent. It means that he is not at all interested in your questionnaire and he is just doing some ticks. So where it is just like sun rises from the east. Everything. Okay, sorry, not this one. Not sun rises from the, this. Unengaged means he's not at all reading it and he is ticking everything. Now what will happen? The mean here will go above 5 and the standard deviation will be almost equal to 0, and this will not work for us. Similarly, here there is one statement in which all of them are ticking 5, 5, 5. For example, I am asking to a professor that should you be given 7 pay, salary should be according to the 7 pay. So all of it, they say yes, 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 yes. And therefore here, this will now become truth. And when truth is there, mean will be again equal to 5, standard deviation will again become to 0, and now there is no more variance in this. And this statement will not work for us. Okay. So what we want, we should want that the statement should vary here like this way also. And the statement should vary this way also. Okay. Is it clear? Fine. Let's proceed. So that is known as problem in data or problem of outliers. Let's proceed. Now I'm talking about achieving the discriminant validity or not. So all of you click in discriminant validity. And there is a criterion which is known as Forner-Larkin criterion. This criteria is just a square root of the average variance extracted, AVE. If you take the square root of this, you will get the Forner-Larkin criteria. This one. Okay. This one. This. Now, what is the interpretation of this is, the interpretation is basically these are all correlations. These are all correlations. And what is the, how to interpret it? That diagonally, the value should be maximum. The value should be maximum in respective columns and rows. All of you, please check it. Is it happening? If it is there, then write down in the chat box, done. Are you getting the same values? Please check it, all of you. If you forget the values, that sir, we have forgotten the values, you can also click on the graph of heterotrade and heterotrade monotrade. Now, if you get any value here which is lesser, then there is a problem of cross loadings. What this cross loading is, I will explain again. Then there is known as biasness in Forner and Larkin criteria. There was a biasness, and therefore Professor Ringel came out with a new ratio which is known as heterotrade and monotrade ratio. How this is calculated, if time permits, I will show it. So go in HTMT, and the HTMT values are the ratio of square root of AVE to correlation. If the ratio is higher than 0.85, we can say that we have achieved the discriminant validity. You can see all of them are in green and there is nothing to worry. Go in the graphs, and if everything is green, go in this graph. If everything is in green, there is no problem here. Now, what is the problem of cross-loading? The problem of cross-loading is same. Just recall my example. One sports person, he wants to be in swimming also and football also. So here, this sports person is getting loaded on this factor also, on this factor also, and this factor also. See, it's loading 0.86 and 0.83, which is not allowed. If we get this, this is known as cross-loading, discriminant validity lost. Two torch focus are overlapping, and we are not able to get the proper validity. Still, those who are confused between reliability and validity, I will give you another example. The reliability is basically talking about the reproducibility of the result. It means that if the same experiment is repeated after some time, if the same survey is done after some time, what are the chances that it will give me the same answer? So that is reliability. And the validity talks about that, are we measuring what we want to measure? For example, can I use the weighing machine to measure the blood pressure? No, because my statement, listen carefully. The weighing machine is not the valid instrument to measure the blood pressure. Okay, so what we should have a proper tool which can measure a blood pressure. And therefore, we should have a proper statement which can measure only that particular construct. And this statement should not overlap each other. What is the remedy of cross-loading? Remove that indicators which are cross-loaded. Reframe the question. Probably the respondents are getting confused that this statement belongs to loyalty or this statement belongs to satisfaction. And that's the reason of confusion which is there. Go in collinearity statistics if you want to find out which is a statement which is creating a problem. Collinearity should be less than 3. Higher than 5 is not at all tolerable. Please check. How will you go in collinearity statistics? Here is the collinearity statistics there. This is known as variance inflation factor, VIF. So this will give me the performance of the, yes, Muskan madam, I will answer, ma'am. This outer VIF gives me the performance of individual team players. And inner VIF gives me the overall performance of the team, of the construct. Both of them should be having the value greater than 3. Both of them should be having the value greater than 3. Is there any other question now? Yes, Muskan ma'am. Allow Muskan ma'am to speak. Please allow Muskan ma'am to speak. Organizers.
Technical team, please unmute Muskan ma'am.
Done, ma'am. Done.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Sir, I just have a confusion, sir.
Please.
Is the same process followed with formative scale also?
No, ma'am. No. For formative scale, we will have to go in a different way. Why? I will answer. In a formative, we will have to go for a different way. That is coming. That was on my way. Okay. See, okay. This was there. Right. There are two approaches to that. Is one is a single global item, and that is another is, first of all, we will have to identify that are my constructs formative or reflective. Now, why this concept is different in formative and reflective, let's try to understand. So ma'am has raised a very valid question. What is the philosophy and behind this, both of them? Let's try to understand. See, what I said is that when there are consequences, when the statements are more or less consequences, we are using reflective. And when they are causes, the statements are formative. Now, what do I mean by this? Same example. a drunk person. A drunk person must be having the slurriness in the speech, difficult to walk, cannot concentrate, memory loss. Okay. Now, if a person is drunk, he will exhibit all these features. He will exhibit all these features. And therefore, there will be a very high correlation among these statements. And as there is a very high correlation among these statements, we are using AVE, Cronbach alpha, rho, which are all emerging from correlation. But if a person wants to get drunk, he can consume different types of alcohol like beer, whiskey, rum. Listen carefully, very carefully. To get in the position of drunk, it is not necessary that he consumes all three of them. He can consume any one of them and still he can reach to this position. And therefore, in case of a formative, there will be a very low correlation among the statements. And that's the reason the reliability and validity measures which are used here are not applicable here. Organizers, till what time I can go?
Sir, this particular session is till 1:30.
Okay, so we can stop and question answer round starts. You can unmute all of them and they can ask questions.
Yeah, technical team, please unmute the raised hand persons.
Sir, as you have said, sir, formative skill, the process will be different. So do we need to do exploratory factor analysis on formative scale, or should we go for only this confirmatory factor analysis and SCM?
Ma'am, when you are in the stage of exploratory, can you define that it is a reflective or a formative measures? Can you define it, ma'am?
No, sir.
No. It is only after doing exploratory you will come to know that probably this may be reflective or formative. Okay. Now, when you are working in SPSS, exploratory effective analysis, the SPSS will never come to know. It does not have any capacity to tell you that this is a reflective or a formative. No, at present, apart from Smart PLS, there is no other software which can identify that this is a reflective or a formative construct.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Is there any other question, ma'am?
Sir, as I am working on my PhD thesis data, sir, there are 12 constructs with 7 to 8 variables in each construct. So when I go for sir exploratory factor analysis, sir, I'm not getting the same variables and as the construct in the same construct, which are meant to be.
It means that there is a problem of cross loading.
So, sir, I am asking, sir, I have sir, justified that was formative scale. Should I go for exploratory factor analysis also, sir? Is it mandatory if our scale is formative?
No. It's not necessary. If you are using a model, then it is not at all necessary. If you are using any celebrated model, it is not at all necessary. One thing more, Smart PLS and R software are measuring are only the softwares which are giving you, ma'am, the measurement models directly, and therefore it is not necessary that you run confirmatory, test the model. So in MOS, what we do, first of all, we make the measurement model. We test it, and then only we make the structural model, right? This is not at all necessary in Smart PLS. Okay, one thing before I forget, my WhatsApp channel is there. You can just send me hello on this number, which is there. I am organizing the training program on various softwares in various universities and colleges. These are the softwares on which I am giving the training. Okay. And this is not a publicity. These are the books which are there available on Amazon of my statistical analysis using R, machine learning using R. There are various programs which I am conducting. You can just send me hello on this. And I will send you the link by which you can be the part of my WhatsApp channel, BM channel. There is no entry fee. You can enter anytime and you can exit anytime. If you feel that it is not useful for me, you can. But by joining it, you will get the notifications of the program. Okay. Any other question is there? Please ask.
So there was a question from Ms. Jasmandeep Kaur in the initial part of your presentation. If ma'am is there, she wants to ask. The question was, what's the difference between SEM and PLS?
No, don't ask the question. Can I talk to that, ma'am?
Okay. Yes, sir, I'm there. So, yes.
Ma'am, yeah, don't. The question is not like this. The question is, ma'am, I will reframe the question for you. If you permit me, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
The question is, what is the difference between covariance based SEM and PLS based SEM? I hope I sound that thing. You want to speak?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. This is in the later part, I myself cleared from your session many doubts which I was having in the starting. So that's why I asked in the starting only.
So this is the thing, ma'am.
Yes, sir. That time this PPT was not visible, and when I asked this question, and okay. After that, so I have got this
Yeah, I will repeat this thing. Smart PLS is having a feature of predictions. It means that you have made a model. See, I will give you an example to all of you. That you must be professor in some university and you must be teaching the students. So just imagine that you have taught them 80 questions. And the same 80 questions are asked in the exam. Naturally, their performance will be much better. So this is happening in the models or in the softwares which are existing at present. You train the model with the cases and you test the performance with the same cases. Naturally, the algorithm will work very nice. But smart PLS is having a concept that forget now 80 questions. Now I will be giving another 20 sets of questions to these students and now I will check them, I will test them. So here there is a concept of training and testing. The second advantage is this is non-parametric. It works on non-normal data. It can work on a small sample size. It is used for theory development and it is having features of formative and reflective. And there is a disclaimer from my side. I don't belong to any political party and I'm not doing marketing of any software. I'm just trying to give you advantages and disadvantages of different software. I'm speaking on many software. I'm not doing any marketing of any software. So any other question is there, please ask. Please ask.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. It's really a very nice informative lecture, sir. You explain all the things very beautifully, but sir, can we use same method for formative analysis, or you can explain how we can analyze or how we can perform formative analysis?
That is coming, ma'am, in the second session, which is at 4, ma'am. This is Bahubali 1. This Bahubali 2 is still coming.
Okay, sir. Okay, Bahubali 2 is still coming.
Yeah.
Okay. So we will conclude formative analysis in that lecture.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
There was a question from Garima Mohit Jindal. If she is there, can you unmute? If she is there. Garima Mohit Jindal. She wanted to know something about convergent validity. Yeah. Sir, I think we'll continue in the second session, sir.
Yes, ma'am. It's okay. And, yes, ma'am.
That will be scheduled at 4:15 p.m.
Okay. Okay.
So, sir, see you again at 4.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.